Praise the Lord, my dear brothers and sisters. Thank you for joining in once again. I pray that this is a moment where we are in. We are almost entering into the most important time, the most important event in the life of every Christian believer. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, yet in a few more hours, we are going to enter into that moment where the greatest act of love took place. Yet as I was preparing for this video today, I was reading this portion, this event that took place today on this Thursday before Good Friday, and it was the most important moment of any leader, of any teacher. Jesus had already completed his 3.5-year ministry, and it was almost coming to a close. And here Jesus had his apostles sent, and he was handing over this ministry to his apostles. There could have been so many things that Jesus could have told his disciples. But what did he say? He not only said it through his words, but also through his actions, so that they shouldn't forget. He did not tell his disciples, he did not tell his apostles that this is what you need to do in order for your ministry to be successful. He did not tell his apostles, this is what you need to do, this is how you need to plan what you are going to talk to people, how you are going to share the message of salvation. He did not give them any leadership training. But what did Jesus tell, and what did he show his apostles? The Gospel of John, chapter 13, verse 14 onwards, it says, "If I then, your Lord and Master, have washed your feet, you also must wash one another's feet." Verses 15. "I have given you an example that as I have done, you also may do. As I have done, you also may do." My dear brothers and sisters, today as we remember that evening when Jesus and his apostles sat, and following that evening, after a couple of hours, Judas walks into the Garden of Gethsemane and plants a kiss on the face of his master. Then Jesus is led to be crucified. My dear brothers and sisters, this evening, let us remember, let us tell ourselves one thing. Jesus was crucified not for something that he did, but Jesus took my place on that cross, and he chose to die for me, so that I can enter the gates of heaven. telling Jesus, Lord, I thank you. I thank you for everything. I thank you for you choosing to die for me. Lord, I am unworthy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.